Hey guys, it's Jennifer here. Finally making another podcast. For those of you who are new, this is my knitting podcast. Slash spinning, slash crafting in general, and also a new thing, needle felting, which is one of the things I'll talk about today. And for today, I'm also gonna do a tiny room tour, because I just maybe no one will notice, but I moved into a new room here at my college. So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys around. It's really tiny, so it's just gonna take like a couple minutes. But I thought I would save that for the end in case people don't care about that and just want to talk about knitting. That's fine. So I'm just gonna get right into it. I think these are all new projects. I'm pretty sure I haven't showed them on the podcast before. I know this one is for sure. So this little one is in this tiny little project bag that I made. It's a drawstring, and it's got buttons on the side, and yeah. So it's going to be, I just started it a few months ago, a couple months ago. Sorry, my yarn is tangled. Because these needles are really curly and they just want to curl up. So I'm not sure if this is going to be a scarf or a cowl. But I did this border stitch. I don't remember what it's called, but it was a new stitch. I'd never done it before, and I really like how it looks. And then it's just regular knitting, and then well, it's stockinette stitch. And then I'm pretty sure these are just yarn overs, if I'm not mistaken. And then more stockinette stitch, and then these are for sure yarn overs. Yeah. So I don't know if it's gonna be like a cowl or like just a scarf. I haven't decided yet. Cause it's still really small, so I have a ways to go before I need to make that decision. So there's one of them. And the yarn, it's like a, I think it's just like wool and some little fibers mixed in. I actually recycled it from a sweater that I had. The sweater was really, really gorgeous. It was from Abercrombie and Fitch, but I got it at like a thrift store or a yard sale or somewhere, I can't remember. And it was really pretty, but obviously I didn't try it on because it was, a yard sale. I think it was a yard sale, but yeah, I didn't try it on, and then I tried it on and it fit me, but it was so itchy, and I can't do itchy. I just can't. So I never really wore it. I wore it like once maybe, and it was really, really thick. So, and it was like all wool, so it was really, really hot. So it just didn't get cold enough for me to wear it, because it was so itchy, you'd have to like wear a shirt under it, like a long sleeve, like probably like a turtleneck, because the neck came up, So anyway, it was too hot. And yeah, so I upcycled it and I've been using the yarn. But I just have like little tiny balls of it, because I wasn't really good at like getting it all out at once and winding it up. So yeah. This is also gonna probably be a pretty short podcast, just because I don't know, just because really there really isn't a reason. I did want to mention, though, that I'm sorry for not making more podcasts. I know it's been like a few months. But a lot of stuff has happened in my life recently. I mean, some of it was bad, but most of it was good. The bad part was last semester, with my roommate, and I'm not gonna talk that much about it just because, it was like personal stuff. But yeah, it stuff happened with my roommate, and so I ended up changing rooms, which is where I'm at now, which is okay. I didn't like how it happened, but I do like having my own room. I wanted one since Well, I wanted one even before I was her roommate. I wanted a single room, but I didn't get one, so we were became roommates. So I'm glad I have my single room now. And I was kind of worried when I first showed up because it's not much, especially like decor wise. Like the furniture they give us wasn't that great, but I really like how it's coming together. It has these giant windows and a heating air unit. Yeah, but I really love the windows and it's really bright in here. Like, if I move this, it might actually be better if I move this over here. Okay, yeah, I moved it over here. So the lighting is a little bit better, I guess. Okay, so yeah, I'm sorry for not, making more podcasts. It's just I've been really busy, and then I was on break at my house, my home in Clinton. So it was, so I didn't. I just wanted to use the time to like relax, and I did have to do stuff at my house, obviously, because that's the type of family I have. Like I have to help my dad and my grandparents with stuff. So I didn't. It was. I was either relaxing or I was doing stuff for them or with them. So. This is the next thing. Like I said, I don't think I've ever showed this on here. It's a crocheted shawl. The design really isn't anything like I just made it up. So there's like, I don't really know if you can see. This is the top. Just heads up. And it's supposed to be getting smaller as it goes down. I can tell that it's getting smaller, but then at the same time, it almost looks bigger. I don't know. It's kind of weird, but I like it. It's really cozy, like really, really soft. The yarn is, I mean. And I just started with. There's just like a lot of holes in it. Like I just would like crochet two and then skip and then crochet two, and that kind of thing. Or like make like chain three, connect it, chain three, connect it. Like that's what I did on this green row. And yeah, and a little stitch marker progress sticker, one that I made. I'm also going to talk about that in this video. I don't know if I've already talked about it once. I can't remember. So I'm gonna talk about it in this one, just in case. So I'm sorry if I already talked about it once, but I just can't remember. Also, there's a noise outside. So I'm gonna pause this and go see what that is. Because I don't know what's going on, but it's loud. Okay, so I'm back. I don't know if that was in the hallway. I went out there. I didn't see anything. I didn't see anyone. I went ahead and used the bathroom while I was out there. Just so I wouldn't interrupt the podcast again. And the bathroom was really dirty. I'm obviously like living in a dorm, and like it's one of the ones where it's different from the one I had last year or last semester. Technically last year, where it's you share a room with someone and you share a bathroom with that person and two other people. So it's the bathroom is as clean as you keep it, but here it's a semi-private bathrooms. So what that means is there's like a floor of girls, which is where I'm at right now, obviously, and there are just bathrooms like on the floor, and they have like the way most of them are set up, or at least the ones at my college, is like there's like a little sink area like with paper towels and a towel rack and soap and that kind of thing where you can wash your hands or brush your teeth or even like put makeup on. And then there's a door that leads into the actual like bathroom, like with a shower and a toilet and another sink. And then these have like little cubby holes, not cubby holes, but like a cubby hole, like where you could like sit down or like put your shower stuff there. That's what I do with the cubby hole, but. Yeah, so like someone could be taking a shower and then the other person could use the mirror and like brush their teeth or do their makeup, whatever. This is also like an all girls dorm, so that's kind of another reason maybe. There was just a lot of hair everywhere. where like someone had come in and brushed their hair, did their hair, and just didn't clean any of it up. And it was kind of gross, but you know, public college, so what you gotta deal with. Okay, so I was just showing the shawl. I think I said that's a shawl. Yeah, so that's those two, and I'm almost out of yarn for that, so I'm gonna have to get some more. Don't know when I'm gonna do that. Like, I need any more yarn. I have like a giant that thing. I just put that up yesterday because it was just sitting on my floor, and I was like, okay, I can't deal with this anymore. So, another thing, I don't think I talked about this in the last podcast. It's been so long, and I'm so forgetful. I know I have showed. I'm fairly certain that I have showed before the socks that I was working on the podcast. They were a fluke, to say the least. I just couldn't figure it out. I could not figure out how to put in the heel, and I tried to watch stuff on YouTube. I tried to read stuff. I just couldn't do it. I couldn't figure it out. So, or well, okay. Okay, that's not true. I figured out how to put in the heel. I put in the heel, but then I couldn't figure out how to make the little corner. I don't know what that's called. The corner where, like, the rest of the sock conjoins with the heel and then, like, goes into the foot. I couldn't figure out how to do that. I don't know what it's called. But yeah. So then I restarted and I did toe up. But I started with a different yarn. Because I decided that it would probably be easier and quicker to do a sock with bulkier yarn. So I'm doing it with this, and it's kind of big. I feel like they're gonna be more like slippers, like just house socks, like than anything else. It kind of looks weird and crooked right now, but I don't know why it looks that way. Yeah, so obviously the first mistake is I cast on too many stitches. So the toe is really square, but I've heard some people like that, so you know. And so far, I'm not gonna do anything because I really like how this yarn is, like how it has the color variations. So I'm just gonna do stockinette all the way, like the whole thing, and then a ribbed cuff. And I can't decide if I want to do toes, cuffs, and heels in this cream color. I just don't know if I have enough. I mean, I could always buy more. I was also gonna say this is a cotton yarn. It's just full cotton. That's another reason I feel like they're gonna be house slippers. Because they're not like elastic or anything, so they wouldn't really do good with like wearing them in shoes all the time and that kind of thing. So yeah. And the yarn is peaches and cream cotton yarn. They come in like little skeins. So I could buy some more, like another tiny skein of this. But the reason I'm using this color, well, using both of these colors for these socks, is I have a lot of this color in my stash, and so I thought it would be good to finally get rid of some of it. And I had some, well, I had some of this also, but I had both of them in stash, and so I was like, oh, okay, I can use this and get rid of it, blah, blah, blah. And so I really don't want to have to like go buy another skein and then have some left over of that when I'm trying to like get stuff done out of my stash. But I don't know, I guess you gotta do what you gotta do if you want your socks to look nice. I just went into needle felting, or well, I started it last semester, and I mentioned it in my last podcast, I think, about how I wanted to start doing it. And so for like a Christmas present to myself, I just did it. I just got the stuff, and I did it. I'll get my first one that I made. I got my other two little things. The very first thing I made was this little guy, which I am very proud of for like my first time. I didn't watch any well, I watched tutorials before I did it, but not a tutorial for this. This was just like all freehand, I guess you could say. He has a little tail, little cheeks, and I didn't give him a mouth because I didn't know how to do it. But he's really, really soft because the fiber is alpaca. And well, it's so some of it is not alpaca. That's how it is. So that was the very first thing I did. I still really like it. I still really like how it turned out. The second thing that I made, and I did use, I made a wire outline, and then I went over it in yarn, and then I felted the wool on top of that. And then the other thing I made, which I love dearly, was what the little lamb that I showed earlier. I love her so much. She doesn't have a name. She has a little bow in her hair. And I mean, she's not perfect. Her eyes are kind of misshapen. but you know. I sort of did the same thing with this. It has like a wire skeleton and you can move its legs. Just like have one sticking way out. Yeah, its legs move and she can stand up. Maybe not on my hand, but yeah, on my hand too. She's kind of like, girl, what? That's the face I feel like she's making. But yeah. I didn't use a tutorial for her either. I just freehanded it again. And then I kind of took a break for a little while, and but then I did. Or well, I made this little guy first. I don't really like him. He's my least favorite. I liked him a lot when I started, but now I don't like him anymore. He's really tiny, and it's just like a weird. It's like a beaver tail, and rabbit ears, and like Satan eyes. It's just like a weird little critter that I made. I don't know. I kind of almost feel like I should throw him away or something. Because I don't know. I don't know. I just don't like them very much. I don't know what to do with them. And my other little things, I just use them as decorations right now because I don't know what else to do with them. So they're just like decorations around my room. Like I need more decoration, right? But anyway, yeah, he's kind of weird. He's the weird one. And so then I took a break. I made him, and then I took a break for a while. I was home. I didn't really do anything. I mean, I knitted a little, but I didn't sew or do anything like that. And then last night, after I cleaned my room some and just chilled, I decided I would make this little mushroom. Well, it's not that little, it's the biggest thing I've made so far. And it's just a little mushroom, it's got some speckles. And yeah, I really like how the. This is supposed to be like moss. I really like how the moss turned out. It looks really moss-like. It is also. It has. Okay, I didn't start out with a wire skeleton on this one, but then I realized, like, I made the mushroom part first and it wouldn't stand up. And of course, I could just, like, lay it somewhere, like, lean it up against something and it would be fine, but I wanted to be able to, like, stand by itself. So then I realized, okay, well, I'm gonna have to make, like, a little stand or something. And then I thought, you know, I could just put grass around the bottom, like make it look like it's on some grass or moss or whatever. So the circle part is wire, and then it goes up, and I pushed it. I had to push it in after I made the mushroom, so you can't like it's not noticeable really, like. But you can't really you can bend it a little because it's you know made out of flexible material, but you know it doesn't bend that much. I really like this. I really like how it turned out. And I've just been sitting it, oh well, I guess I'll show you that next, because I'm about to do the room tour in the next couple minutes. And then I also just wanted to talk about, I got some, I didn't buy this first. I just used fiber that I had because you know, I've already started spinning. So, to make the bunny and the sheep and the little guy, I just used wool that I already had. I did have to go and buy the wire to do it. I'm just gonna go ahead and get my little needle felting box out. I also bought this. Oh, it looks like it got crushed. That's not good. I also bought this little box to carry my needle felting around in and keep it safe. It's kind of just turned into like a storage box now, but it has my let me see it there. It has my needles in it, which I broke one last night for the first time. I like snapped it in half. I have no idea where the pointy end went. But yeah, I'm just gonna kind of It has like wool that I dyed. This is the wool that I dyed. It's one of this big colorful mass. And then some wool that I bought, like had dyed and bought that. And yeah, and so when I was working, like, because the sheep took me a little while. And so I would just put it in there and carry it, you know, if I wanted to go work on it someplace, I would just carry it with me. Also, my hair keeps falling down. So yeah, that's just what I keep it in. And I think that's all I need. Well, I was gonna talk about this. So I bought this. This was really the gift to myself because, like I said, like I just had to go out and buy the little needles and the wire when I first started, and obviously that wasn't that expensive, but this was like $20, I think. Less than that, maybe, which isn't that, it's not expensive. But I was a little disappointed when I got it. I bought it off Etsy from a seller. I have the card somewhere, but I think it's like just Happy Yarns or something. I'm not sure. But I bought it from her, and she was really nice, the seller, because I had some issues with it arriving on time. Because I did order during the holidays, it kind of took like an extra day to get here, or extra 2 days or something, which wasn't that big of a deal. She was really nice about it and tried to help me. But what I didn't like, first of all, I told her that I wanted pastels, which it's kind of like pastel-y on this side and then like black on this side. So some of the colors were darker than I wanted. But I did also say, you know, oh, just add in some stuff, you know, like this is some stuff that I want specifically, and then the rest you can just throw in whatever, you know. So I guess that was sort of on me for not specifying. But what really bothered me was the quality. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see. I know you can see like that, like those specks of dirt. There's a lot of dirt on this side. And I'm showing the white because it'll be the easiest to see. But there's like dirt all in it. And I don't know if, like I said, it wasn't that expensive, but I didn't get, like, this is what I got, was this for like like a little bit less than, I think it was like $18 or something. So like it's not that much, but it wasn't that expensive, but I just wasn't expecting the quality to be that bad, and it's like it's just not clean, and that's something that bothers me. I don't like to buy stuff and feel like it's not clean. It's just, I don't know, it's just something that bothers me. Because there's like little bits, like in the white, there's like little bits of like black and that kind of thing, and then they're all that way. It also looks like in a lot of them, especially the pink, because pastel pink was something I asked for specifically. And I don't even have to take it out of the bag. You can see in the bag that it wasn't carded completely. Like it was partially carded, and there's still streaks of color that's not blended properly enough, like for my taste. And it didn't really, I don't remember if she even had pictures up for this type of order. I don't remember, but I don't know. To me, it wasn't that great of quality. And I didn't ever say anything to her about it because some of the colors I did like I really like, but I mean, even this orangey yellow, it's still not, like there's still streaks of stuff in it. But like I liked that gray color, and I liked some of it. I didn't like some things about it, so I probably won't buy anything from her again. I kind of like that green color, but it isn't carded super well either. But that one, it seems like that was done on purpose. Just like with this one here. Don't know if you can see. You can sort of see, like, talking about this one, how it has all those different colors, but that was done on purpose. Like you can tell that it was done on purpose. So while I don't really like that color, you know, it doesn't look poorly made. You know what I mean? So I didn't have a problem with that. So I don't know. So like I said, there's some things I didn't like, some things I like. So I just decided to not ask for my money back. Because I just, oh, like it had already taken like extra time to get there, and I didn't want to have to pay for like return shipping and that kind of thing. So it was kind of a bust. But, you know, at the same time it wasn't, because I do like some of it. Like it wasn't all horrible. Okay, and then the last thing I wanted to talk about was this. This is gonna be kind of messy now because all my knitting stuff is out. I guess I'm gonna move my knitting stuff while I talk about this last thing. I wanted to talk about my progress keepers that I've made, and like I said, I don't think I've talked about it on here. If I have, I'm sorry for bringing it up again. But I don't know. I'm hoping someone will give me their opinion, but probably not because not that many people watch my podcast. But I'm just wondering what would be a good way about trying to go about a good way to try and sell these, not on a huge level, just like a little bit, like a little bit at a time, like a small business type thing. I'm gonna go ahead and show some of them. Basically, the main ones that I make are sort of like this. It's just like little beads, and it has a lobster clasp. They're more like progress keepers than stitch markers, but sometimes I accidentally call them stitch markers. Or, yeah, well, they could be like if you wanted to hold a specific stitch, they could do that, but it's not like it wouldn't be one of those ones where you can, like, it doesn't go on your needle. Let's just put it that way. Like, it goes in your knitting. And I do different variations of different beads, like, and different lengths. So, like, this is three beads, that one was two beads, but they all have the same little clasps. And I also recently got some of these beads, which I really like. I don't know if I'll sell these or if I'll just keep them for myself because I really like them. But the bottom on this one messed up, so I think I'm going to redo it. And then I also have some little, like, charm type ones. This one is a squirrel. And then the ones I have right now are sort of like forest themed. So, like, squirrel, this is a pine cone. This one isn't forest themed, this is a separate one. This is a unicorn, which I only have two of these right now, so those are mine. Those are mine for right now, but if someone wanted to buy some, I could definitely get some and make some more. And then here's a creepy little deer. I really don't like this deer, it creeps me out. But it's cute, but it's also creepy. And someone would probably really like it. And then here's a little leaf, maple leaf. So yeah, and then I have another one that's a bunny, but I'm using it right now because it's my favorite. And then the other type of beaded one that I make is just like a single bead for people who don't like a lot of stuff on their knitting. So I'm just wondering, like, I want to sell some. Like, I want to make some to sell. But I don't know where to sell them at. I did start an Etsy store, but I deleted it because it was too worrisome. Like, I just worried about it too much with, like, the fees and things. Like, because I don't know how that works, and I didn't have anyone to teach me, and I just worried me too much, so I just deleted it. I'm gonna get a drink. I'm having peach tea. Haven't ever tried it. It's my first time trying it. I know this mug. It's not cute. It's not cute, but it gets the job done. The actual reason I'm using this is because, well, I'll show it to you in the little tour I'm about to do, but my grandma gave me this coffee maker that she had, but it's just like a one serve Or like it's really like two servings, I guess, like two serving coffee cup coffee maker. So you just put the cup in, like you put, well, you put water in the cup, dump it in, you know, blah blah. And I've only made coffee with it so far, but then today I was like, I kind of don't. I wanted coffee, but then I was like, I don't really need like the extra sugar. Because I've started a diet, or well, not a diet, but sort of a diet, but like I'm trying to count my calories and stay, you know, within a certain number. So it's just calorie counting. It's not really like a specific diet that I'm on. So I just didn't want the extra sugar, and so I thought, well, you know, I could just use it to warm the water up and then just put the tea bags in. So that's what I did. And it's pretty good. It's not very sweet. But it's pretty okay. Anyway, so yeah, that's all for the stitch markers. And there's obviously, ooh, ah, I dropped that. Okay. Yeah, this is the little baggie that I keep my stitch markers in. Sometimes they fall out, but not usually. I made this little baggie. That's why I'm showing it. I really, really like it a lot. It's really cute, in my opinion. And the inside is green. Mint. Mint green. Anyway, so there's that. And yeah, so now I'm gonna do the room tour really quick. So, time for the room spin, pretty much, because it's so tiny. Okay. So, this is part of it, my giant wall hanging. I have my yarn up there, poster, and then here's my bed. And then this is where I keep, oh, that's a dirty towel. Okay, let me just get that. Doesn't go up there. That's where I hang up all my bags and stuff, my purse. That's where I put my backpack. This is like a shower cover for when I go take a shower, because like I said, the bathrooms are open, so anybody can see me if I don't cover up. And then I have my cleaning stuff, my umbrella. That's my dirty clothes and my trash can. And I have my fridge, my microwave, and my teacups, which I finally have a place for. I finally brought them. They've been like at home this whole time. There's the mirror. And then my closet with stuff up there, my sewing machine. Right now I'm just keeping it inside its box because my desk, as you're about to see, it's not crowded, but it is full, like with my printer. And then I have my dream catcher awkwardly on this thing because I don't know what to do with it. And then this floor space over here, I'm hoping that this is at the right angle. Right now, there's not really anything there, but I have plans to bring in my floor pillows from home and put them along in here just for like an extra place to sit, really. Because right now, it's just a chair in my bed. And to get into my bed, I have to use my chair. Or my stepladder. I do have a stepladder. So yeah, I just want to bring them in so I can have an extra place to sit if I want to. Not have to sit in my bed so much or at my desk. Because that kind of hurts my back after a while. But anyway, I haven't done that yet. But I will do that soon. And then, you can't really see. This is just some pictures. Picture frames, and then that's my little rabbit and my mushroom, and then some little knick-knack toy thingies that I have. My plants, I keep them down there. They were up here, but I had to move them like every night, and then if I would forget, then like okay, because they were on my AC and I would pull the shade open so they could get light, like sunlight. But then sometimes I would forget, and so then my shade would be open at night, and like the light would be on, and people could see me, and I didn't really like that. So now they're down there, and so during the day, you see, I just kind of open the shade and let them get light. And I thought about putting them over here. I might change, because that's my knitting box. My whole jumble of wires. I don't really like how this looks. So I'm thinking about changing it, but I don't know how I could change it yet. So that's still a work in progress. And then this is my desk. I got, water, and that's the little coffee maker I was talking about. Okay, sorry. I accidentally ended the video. Going back to the desk. There's the coffee maker, and I got my Instax cam over there. Lamp. And now I'll just show you the bed. My yarn. It's up there. I wanted it higher up. See, like I put the hooks, if you can, I don't know if you can see, but I put the hooks like higher up, and then the elastic just like didn't it just like stretched and it didn't bring the whole bag with it. So I don't know if I'm gonna change that. Because it was kind of hard to get it to stay up there because it's so heavy. So I don't know if I'm gonna change or not. Anyway, and then finally there's my bed. I kind of made it this morning. I still need to like dust it off. My dirty. And then there's the stuff under my bed. My storage stuff. Got food in. Dishes and other things. So yeah, guys, that's my room. That's my knitting podcast for this episode. Hope you liked it. Hope you enjoyed the tiny room tour because I have a tiny room. And yeah, I guess that's it. So like this video if you liked it. If you didn't like it, thumbs down, I guess. Hopefully you wouldn't sit through this whole video though if you didn't like it. So anyway, hope you guys have a good day. And I will hopefully see you in a couple weeks, in a month, maybe, maybe, I don't know. All right. Bye, guys.